When you want something you can't have, you work hard to get it. Welcome to society's rules. Thieves feel the need to take things that don't belong to them, whether that's because they're desperate or it gives them the rush. But sometimes they take stuff from people they really shouldn't have. So welcome back to Top 5 Central, everyone, where today we're looking at 5 thieves who mess with the wrong people. If you hate people who steal, leave a like on the video and comment if you've ever had something stolen from you. One lucky person will get pinned for everyone to see. Anyways, let's start with number 5. So obviously stealing is wrong no matter where you do it, but stealing from someone in a graveyard has to be a new low. I mean, the thieves in this story were literally waiting around in a cemetery, just looking for someone to target. As it happened, they picked a dude who was visiting for the first time in 10 years, who had come to pay respect to his late grandfather who was buried there. It's a really sweet story, but it took a turn when the dude noticed his car was being broken into, and he realized he had to do something. That's when the thieves knew they had made a serious mistake, because even though they had knives and he only had fists, the dude made quick work of both of them. Turns out the dude mourning his grandfather was an ex-Marine who had served time in Afghanistan, so the thieves weren't exactly gonna scare him. He ended up with 2 stab wounds and some pretty gnarly bruises, but his car was safe, and he made sure to let everyone know that the thieves looked a hell of a lot worse. Number 4. Now, when it comes to planning a crime, you have to be pretty soulless to target the elderly, but that doesn't stop people from doing it every day, because unfortunately, they're really easy victims. I guess the stereotype is that older people are weaker and less likely to fight back, but that definitely wasn't the case with this next guy. Basically, his house was broken into twice in the same week, and that was enough to get him thinking about revenge. Like, the dude didn't even bother calling the police. He just grabbed his shotgun and set up a trap. How'd he do it? Well, it's pretty simple actually. He just drove his car up the road to make it look like he was out of the house, and then hid in his living room with the shotgun. Less than a day later, he noticed someone creeping around in his home and chased him straight out without thinking twice. Even crazier, when he got back to his house, another thief was still trying to rob him, and it took 2 warning shots to get them to flee in a nearby getaway car. No one was hurt, but that's not the point. The point is that no one's gonna mess with this grandpa again anytime soon. Number 3. Normally when someone breaks into a house, it's because they're looking for something, whether that's money, expensive technology, or even just food. With that said, the weirdest thing about this guy is, he wasn't looking for any of that, he was just hanging out. Seriously, this dude broke into someone else's house and just started wandering around randomly, trying on clothes, sitting on the couch, even watching TV. Like, the dude even grabbed a beer out of the fridge to drink while he chilled out on the couch, which isn't exactly normal thief behavior. Anyway, the actual owner of the house got a security alert because of all the movement, and it didn't take long for him to take action. He and a neighbor grabbed their guns and surrounded the dude, before getting him onto the floor and taping his wrists and ankles. After that, all they had to do was drag him onto the porch and wait for the police to arrive, who confirmed that the dude had been breaking into and stealing clothes from a bunch of houses in their neighborhood. How random is that? Number 2. Speaking of super weird thieving habits, this is another guy who has some seriously random priorities. I mean, when this story started, I was sure he was gonna like try and break into this guy's house, but he was actually more interested in something outside. I know what you're probably thinking, but no, it wasn't the car he was targeting. Turns out it was the mail he was after. I'm not joking, he grabbed it right out of the mailbox, jumped in his car, and just drove away. Luckily, the owner of the house and the mail saw him do it, and unfortunately for the thief, he was no ordinary homeowner. Like, the thief had accidentally targeted the home of a champion MMA fighter who didn't even hesitate before jumping in his own car and chasing him down. Thankfully, it didn't come to any violence because the thief gave up the stolen mail in a heartbeat, but I'm guessing the fear was enough to pull him off a life of crime for a long, long time. Okay, here's our honorable mention. Now, being the victim of a crime is scary no matter what, but if you're a kid, being attacked by a grown-up is even more terrifying. That's what makes this story so impressive, because when the thief tried to burgle this house, he was taken down by an 11-year-old boy. Here's what happened. This kid was home alone when he saw the home invader running out of the house, carrying like a hamper full of all the tech and valuables he could find. You'd think the kid would be scared, but instead, he just got angry and went to find the gun he knew was kept in the house. He told the dude he would kill him if he didn't drop the stuff, and when the criminal just kept running, the kid tried to do just that. It took 11 misses, but the 12th shot he fired caught the thief in the leg, bringing him down and keeping him immobile until the cops came. Here's a quick second honorable mention. I just thought it was really funny, so I thought you guys would enjoy it too. First off, I'm just gonna say this now so you've all been warned. This next guy is kind of a little cringy, but with that said, it's worth remembering that he did save the day in this situation, even if the way he did it is kinda cheesy. Here's the story. This guy carries around a katana with him everywhere he goes. And unlike most people, he actually knows how to use it. So when he saw two guys ganging up on someone and trying to mug them, he didn't even hesitate before trying to do the right thing. Like, he tricked the guys into thinking he was just moving out of the way, but then came up behind the victim and drew his blade. That was actually enough to get the other two guys to back off and leave, but the dude said he had a whole plan to take them down if that didn't work. Like I said, this guy is more than a little goofy, and it doesn't help that he gave a fake Japanese name to the press. But there's no denying that his move to sheathe his katana is actually really freaking cool, and he saved a dude too, so hey, at least it worked, right?
It's about what you saw on the train. It's folded, tempered, and it does its job. My family couldn't handle me. I had a surprisingly strange affinity for sharp objects, particularly kitchen knives, when I was a kid.
So he traded in the knives for a lifetime of studying the sword. The katana goes with him everywhere.
Number one. Okay, let's be real here. If your car was getting broken into, but the criminal was chased away by a guy in an honest-to-God superhero suit, what would you think? I don't know about you, but I'd either think the whole thing was a setup or that I was simply going crazy. Turns out that's exactly what this guy thought when he was rescued from car thieves by a man in a gold and black suit. However, the truth was actually way weirder, because he was actually rescued by one of Seattle's 8 real-life superheroes. I'm being dead serious. The city is full of masked crusaders who walk the streets at night looking for crime to stop, and one actually stumbled on a situation where he could save the day. I don't know if it's super lame or super epic, but either way, I'm guessing this guy was happy he could drive away unharmed, even if the way he was rescued was, well, a little unorthodox. And there's our video on the top 5 thieves who mess with the wrong people. If you enjoyed the video, make sure to hit the like button and subscribe so you see whenever I upload a video. Also, if you're on top 5 or top 10 idea, feel free to search for me handy form down in the description to submit it. With all that said, thank you for watching, hope you enjoyed, have a beautiful rest of your day, and we'll see you all in the next video.